Neither the United States of America nor the world community of nations can tolerate deliberate deception and offensive threats on the part of any nation.
I will make you understand.
Hey, everybody. I'm Tony Jones, and welcome to the Tony Jones Show.
People are willing to take the risk. It's just sort of a herd mentality, a lemming-like mentality. If you don't go with the flow, you're anti-American and therefore a suspect.
The Tony Jones Show, featuring punk, rockabilly, psychobilly, and Providence, Rhode Island's finest, starts right now.
He's a dangerous militia member, I hear. Oh, and there she blows.
friends, the time for mediocrity and broadcasting is over. My name is Tony Jones, and you are tuned in to The Tony Jones Show, your destination for talk and rock. Online at TonyJones.org, on Facebook, Facebook.com/TonyJonesShow. And I am currently, if you're catching the live program, on Twitter, at TonyJonesNRI. And some folks are already checking in over there. Greatly appreciate it. I don't have my glasses on, so I have no idea what you're saying to me. But I appreciate you tweeting in on the program. And I'd be remiss if I didn't mention there's a lot of great things going on over at RIFreeRadio.org. Check that out. We just started off with the Strokes' Under the Cover of Darkness. Very exciting program for you this evening. My alternative media roundtable continues. Now, this is radio, so of course you can't see into the studio. But if you hear the floorboards creaking at some point, let's just say there's a whole lot of sexy in this little broom closet of a studio this evening. And myself included, I probably have the largest waistline. We could line up by waistlines tonight on the Tony Jones Show. Two Tony Jones Show regulars in studio with me, DJ Psycho Eddie is here.
Hello, everybody.
And from the Coalition, the PO taxpayer in the house.
Emphasis on round table.
What I've noticed, PO taxpayer, I want to get right into it, and I want to start off with you. DJ Psycho Eddie has a ton of stuff coming up. He's like me. He rarely turns down work. I don't know if it's because he's as cheap as me or if he's as bored as me, but he's like me. He rarely turns down work, except for, of course, we talked a little bit about off the air. The one thing I turned down recently was my opportunity to be in a magazine called Guys and Fries, which...
which I would have taken in a heartbeat.
See, you would have been great on that. Although, no, you being Irish, you would only needed one fry to cover it, right?
Crinkle cut.
But Guys and Fries is, and you can Google it if you so choose. It is.
Please don't.
I want to say healthy men, and they pose in centerfold style glossy magazine with different food items. So I was asked to partake in Guys and Fries, but I unfortunately had to turn that down. Now, what I want to talk about with UPO is the fact that people are just irate by the fact that you use the moniker PO taxpayer. I mean, people are going nuts on you.
And it feels good.
Do they not have anything better to do?
I'm not sure, Tony. frankly, I don't get it. But the more upset they get, the more I do it. It seems to really piss them off, we like to say. There's this obsession with keyboard courage, and somehow they claim I don't have keyboard courage. I will tell you that the things that I spew online, that I spew on the radio, I've said directly to the very people.
Right, I'm the same way.
In the flesh. I mean, there's nothing I won't say, not for nothing, nothing I won't say, not say, to a politician. I in one of my first forays into talk radio years ago, I proposed an idea, which I think has some philosophical merit. I called it Insult Your Favorite State Employee Day. All right. Find a state employee, random, hopefully of middle to higher level management, and just say something incredibly rude to them, smile, say have a nice day, and walk away. I think it would be cathartic, if not therapeutic.
See, I have the opposite. Everybody thinks that I use a fake name because my name sounds fake. However, that is indeed my real name. And I'm the same way. I take the same philosophy as that, you know. Come on, let's talk about it. Let's have a moment. Let's have a come to Jesus moment if you want to talk about it. It's when I was a kid, it was, now, you know, obviously you guys all have a few years on me, but we had the opposite thing.
One or two.
From Keyboard Courage, we had telephone tough guys where a guy would call you up with *67 and say, hey, fat boy.
Now, I just want to step in for one second. I agree with the state employee what you think day, and I do that on a regular basis, which is probably why I have not advanced into management in my own daily job. I have a hard time keeping my mouth closed at work.
So it's a filters issue, a boundaries issue.
Oh, I don't have filters.
You know, it's funny that you mention insult as state employee day, because I was behind someone in traffic driving here to the studio today that had their state representative license plate. So
oh.
It said State Rep District 36, for instance. Maybe that's what it was. Maybe it wasn't.
And said state rep has refused to return my calls and emails and my more calls and my more emails, as you guys know and probably a lot of listeners know, regarding the legalization of marijuana. I'm kind of on the front lines of that movement, and I can't get a call back from my state rep. And I happen to be behind him because, of course, we live in a small town in traffic today. And I was thinking, should I sidle up on the side of this guy in my car?
WWPOD, what would PO do? Yeah, see, PO would have actually just gotten a lounge chair, an extra couple of flamingos, and an adult beverage, and just sat up on his front lawn one day and, read copies of the Providence Journal. I mean, and then all of a sudden the police show up, and that's how I get yet another restraining order. But I don't think – here's the key. We need to get into people's grill, particularly after the events of this week. And when I say get into people's grill, you need to be on target, on focus, talking points, machine gun-like sarcasm. As far as I'm concerned, if you take that approach, there are no limitations. There are no boundaries. You have to get right up into them. You have to treat these people. Eddie, let me ask you. If someone broke into your house and stole your new flat screen, you'd be pretty pissed off.
He has two pit bulls.
I have two pit bulls.
Okay. Then you'd actually be enjoying it.
If they could make it in and out with that flat screen, I would actually pay them to find out how they did it.
Okay. Well, these people who allegedly run our state are stealing from us in the fully the literal sense. And one need only go as far as the appointment of the esteemed judicial scholar Richard Leach,
or as I like to call him, the Leach.
The Leach, this week, to see that they're just literally stealing from us. So I treat them like what they are, common criminals. Would you be nice to the B&E artist? Would you be nice to the guy selling nickel bags on your... Well, actually,
yeah. I would.
There you go. Sorry, you might be...
I say, come on in, cuz.
See, I treat everyone with a smile, even when I'm telling them to go pound sand or whatever colorful four-letter serenade I'm giving them. Wow, words is not... Meds are either kicking in or dropping off. I'm not sure which it is. But yeah, I'm always doing it with a smile, which is a little unnerving.
Right.
Because that just adds to why I've earned the moniker, and that I actually earned the name Psycho Eddie. And this is no secret, when I started DJing, I was in a strip club, and
I'm jealous already.
I literally would help the bouncers break up fights. I would run down the main stage of said strip club and Superfly. Jimmy the Superfly Snooker. I would Superfly a whole group of people to break up a fight. And usually it was the wrong group of people that I would Superfly.
Stuff happens.
Like Tony, at the time I needed glasses, but that's how I earned the name.
So embrace, I think you and I think everybody in this room actually embraces confrontation.
Oh, yes.
And as you guys both know from dealing with me on a regular basis, I start off very nice and very professionally. And I'm a pretty laid-back guy. Until you just act like an idiot, and then I just can't take it. I literally cannot physically take stupidity lately.
Because it's everywhere, on every level, on everything you do, and particularly here in Rhode Island. There just seems to be no limit to just how god-awful, how far they can push the buttons. It's almost like you're having a contest to see what they can get away with. And again, this week was a perfect example. I mean, you lower taxes that no one here pays, the corporate income tax, and you lower the estate tax, and you increase fees to the rest of us for the 30 or so people in this state who are still making some sort of living. And then they smile at us and pat our heads and, move along. There's nothing to look at here.
Of course, you know what I'm supporting, and that is no sales tax on big and tall clothing. And I think that could be a game changer for this state.
I think so, too. But, I mean, what's our mantra on the coalition? We believe in raising all taxes we don't have to pay. So
that's a good segue. Speaking of the coalition, what I'm going to do is spin some tunes. Then I kind of want to work backwards. When we come back, I'm going to have DJ Psycho Eddie tell us about DJ Psycho Eddie, what he does, a little reminder. Then we'll talk a little bit about what the coalition is and does and what PO Taxpayer does besides being a troll's troll on Twitter and Facebook. But before that, we're going to hear from the band that's going to be in studio with me next week. They're from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. They're called Only on Weekends.